Dear friends, this is the part two of our lecture concerning this valuations. As I told you, how to pass this exam of valuation is the first part of my discussion. And as you know that I have taken this exam several times, and every time when you miss, you have been thinking how to pass this exam. And I had a real problem in the sense there were a lot of mistakes in the questions. For example, they want you to compute a payback period, and in that payback period they never gave outflow, and then inflows for 3 years, 4 years they have given. So it is not possible to calculate. So there are a lot of such mistakes were there, and I tried to bring it to the notice of them. And then definitely there were my assessment was that there were a lot of mistakes, possibly because it is crowdsourced. That was the same problem expressed by many of our friends. So luckily, as I told you, things have been a bit better. And now if you want to pass this exam, how to go about it? Let me be very clear on this. In the last exam when I came, I made sure that first, when you write the exam and then you fail, then you don't take too much time. You write the next day or thereafter. So don't give too much of time. This is the rule number one which I have learnt. So there is nothing more for you to read also, because you have already read. And it is a real boring things to ensure that always you keep reading. I found it is very difficult. But I can tell you, friends, I studied very well, extremely good. And first, I went through the institute materials. I'll just give you the background. I attended the ICI material. They have conducted, they charge 35,000 or something. Now, the different classes were taken with due respect to the teachers, which I know, since I am a teacher, I felt they were not useful to the classes really, except for Mr. M.P. Vijay Kumar, who took the introductory class. He is really a good teacher. And see, what is the use of the classes? What exactly we are expecting? We have to pass this exam, that's all. And then they wasted a lot of our time, and therefore I attended only ICA classes because I am a chartered accountant. Honestly, I can tell you it is a waste. But then we have to pay that 50 hours thing. In fact, some teachers were telling about certain things, the insolvency code, which is long back. The ordinances have come earlier. And therefore, I felt I'll be inconvenient. It was inconvenient for them to sit in the class. And they told me, we'll give you attendance. Why don't you go? You seem to know everything like that. Anyway, I don't want to, maybe I didn't properly. And I'm comfortable in subject one. But institute has provided with a very good electronic form, online, Sarika Madam and Dinal Shah. These are the two. I think they have done a very good work. They were very kind. See, mistakes do come. It is a first time. So let's not criticize them. It is being for the first time since we have started. There could be some problem. But the quality of material is very good. Institute material is really good. And online exam test and all, we took it later. So I felt they could have at least told us this is a highly exam, we have to pass the exam. From that angle, I think it was not very useful for us, is my view. No, let me not, they might have improved all that. And there were a lot of, because you are the first to second batches, a lot of issues were there. I came to know from my friends, I must thank them, because I don't want to project as if it's my knowledge and all. I'm always learning. So first step is we had a great help from my friend Yogesh Sundaram. He attended, and first time itself he cleared 75 marks he got. And then he himself remembered all the questions, and then he tried to put it in a WhatsApp group. And next we got Anita. She was my student, but she did a great help for me. She helped so many people. Literally, she was sincere in her service. So I think she had also helped me a lot. And of course, I should not forget my student again, Hemant. Hemant passed much earlier than all of us, and he tried to spread the message, and he really took it forward. And ICAA, everywhere he studied, and he gave me books, everything he gave me, so I can't forget him. And then Venki sir is there, and he also did a lot of help for me. So it's not a one-man show thing. But what is the real way in which you will pass? I'm giving you example to pass. Last exam, when I got this 70 marks, I realized to pass this exam, you have to be very good in the case studies. Because 7 into 2, 14 marks will come. 7 into 2, 14 marks will be awarded for the exam. And if you don't get it, then where is the question of passing? Because there is a negative marking is there, 90 questions you have to take, and suppose you say 60 marks is you have to get to pass, and so say 30 questions go wrong maximum, let us say 30 go wrong, that means 8 marks they will remove, 8 will be out. So you will 60 correct, you are writing 90 questions, and then in that 8 marks is wrong, you will never pass the exam. So for passing, first and foremost step is you have to be very, very good in the case studies. Very, very good means what? They will give you a case studies. They have only limited cases. So that is first step is you don't need to be expert. Free cash flow, like that, I'll now read out the questions. Now I went to the exam, the last exam. By then I knew case studies I knew, but I don't know the answers. What is the correct answer also they don't publish. So that is the biggest problem. Most of the questions, if you go 3 times in 3 days, you will get every question is repetitive. So you need answers for that questions and the correct answers. Even you can do correct answers, they may mark you wrongly in the computer. This is the problem. And now they have sorted out is what I feel. Otherwise, I would not have passed this exam. So first and foremost step is I went, and this is a free cash flow problem. And you know, even you want to solve this problem, it is not possible for you to solve within that time. So therefore, attempting to solve it, I think is you are venturing into risk, is my thing. So I remembered the answer for the problem. This free cash flow problem, how to remember? One is a calculate weighted average cost of capital. That is 12.71. 12.71 is the answer. Second is, the next is, what is the answer? This is a firm, value of the firm, something 11.38. And third one is 300 lakhs. Another is 220. This is the answer for that question. Now, this is the 4 into 2, 8 marks, you sure? In fact, before I took up the exam, I just called Madam Anita and asked her what could be the answer for this question. Again, she said, I had a doubt, which is 300 and which is 220. And value of the firm and value of the equity. And this is because there are two things will be there. When you are valuing, there are two flows are there. One is the yearly flows and another is the terminal flow. So, when you bring them to present value, value will be lesser. And so when I just opened that question came, so I just ticked that, I remembered it, 12.71, 11.80, 300, 220, tuck, 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 we ticked. The next question, that is 3-6 marks question, is again, they will say, this is what they will say. That is, companies are there, undervalued and overvalued shares. Whenever you have a situation where you identify undervalued share. What is undervalued share?